Welcome to the 2015 Holiday Bowl, which is staged for its 38th game and will pit the Big Ten against the Pac-12 for the second year in a row. This season, we'll get to see a great USC passing game against a top-notch Wisconsin defense. Despite their five losses, the Trojans are as dangerous as anyone going into this bowl season and will present a very tough matchup for the Badgers. Cody Kessler didn't quite live up to the Heisman hype he had coming into this season, but he still did enough to help his team to success, passing for 3,128 yards and 27 touchdowns. They can move the ball through the air with Kessler and the uncoverable Juju Smith-Schuster, or on the ground with Ronald Jones II. The pass defense has been sneaky good as well. They're not a perfect team, but they're more than talented enough to pick up another bowl win this holiday season. Wisconsin, perhaps, had the least talked about 9-3 season in the country after losing to Alabama and Iowa early in the season. The Badgers' biggest problem is that they haven't been themselves on offense. The passing game seemed to be improving earlier in the season, but is still average at best. The running game, which was so effective last year with Melvin Gordon, hasn't been the same this year without supposed star Corey Clement, who missed part of the season with injury. He will play in this game today, so we'll see how he does. The good news for Wisconsin is that the defense is top-notch, with linebacker Joe Schubert arguably the best linebacker in the Big Ten, and Michael Caputo is one of the best safeties. The Badgers can be in any big game because of this defense. Now they have to win one. Hopefully you enjoy this exciting matchup here today. We have at the 2015 Holiday Bowl.
Players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Fires quickly to the tight end. He's taken down
at about the 35.
Number 93 makes the tackle at the 35-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
That's a great tackle at the 22-yard line.
Gain of 13 on the play. First down.
From the 22-yard line, it's first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
Called a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
He's tackled at the 22.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
Another run. Tackled after a decent pickup.
You know, great effort here by the ball carrier, but I think they need to pass in that situation most of the time.
So it's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. USC could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Zips it to the tight end. And down he goes around the 35-yard line.
That's a big gain there for the offense. And all that's doing is giving this quarterback more and more confidence.
From their own 35-yard line. First down. On the draw, tackled in the backfield.
Loss of 2 yards on the play.
Got a receiver and he dropped it.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
Three down, three down.
Third down and 13. Ball on the 33-yard line. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Meyer to punt. He's pushed out of bounds at the 39.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
USC holds a field goal lead. And he's tackled at the 41.
Gain of two on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Throws incomplete, broken up.
Your instincts tell you to go for the pick, but you've got to make the best play you can, and sometimes it's just batting the ball away.
Now it's third and nine coming up. Ball on the 41-yard line. He airs it out. Caught. Tackle around the 17-yard line. The tight end came up with a nice catch that time.
Yeah, the big fella's pretty athletic for a tight end, and as a quarterback, it's always nice to have a big target like this to go to.
Quick throw, almost intercepted. From the 17-yard line, second down. And he's stopped behind the line. It right side, and he's got it going the other way. Now
he telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 20.
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
So that sack will back them up a little now. They're looking at a difficult third and 13.
Three down. 86 to man. 86 to man. Go, 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 go. Mike 55. Eat.
Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Rodgers is back awaiting the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And down he goes at the 46.
Boy, neither offense can find any kind of rhythm so far, Herbie.
Yeah, it almost feels like the two offenses are just kind of feeling their way right now, allowing both these defenses just to dominate the game.
Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
USC has a three-point lead. Nice run there.
That's a gain of six on the play.
On the ball.
That'll make it second and four.
Hey, kill.
Fires out to his receiver. And they make the stop at the 46-yard line. Loss of about six.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. Hey. taken down at the 39-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
Up the middle for a nice gain.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Man up the gut. Tackle made at the 33.
No gain. That'll bring up third and four.
Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Yeah, let's go sack lunch.
The defense has got to be thinking, if they've already forced a red zone turnover, maybe they can do it again right here.
Brought down at the 16-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Ready to kill. Gain 15.
He fights forward to about the 16.
No gain on the play. That makes it third and seven.
This is the ninth play of this drive. USC is up by three. He's under pressure. And he is drilled at the 19.
Loss of three on the play. Fourth down.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. The kick is up, and he's got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. They'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
USC's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. From their own 18-yard line, second down. Looks for his tight end over the middle. They'll bring him down right around the 30.
That makes it first and 10.
Run left and he'll lose yardage. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. We've played one quarter. USC leads it 6-0. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. He's under pressure. Quick pass, intercepted. And he hits him hard at the 37-yard line. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
From the 37-yard line, first down. USC with a 6-point lead. He tackles him hard at the 38.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Second and 12.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. They'll drop him for a loss.
Here's a throw, and it's almost picked. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position of this football game. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
Brett, everywhere we go when we travel all over the country, people want to talk about offense. Oh, the spread or the pistol. Hurry up, tempo offense and points. It's nice to watch a team that prides itself on playing great defense. And when it's all said and done, the teams that advance and get to the important bowl games and do well in the postseason are teams that have this kind of defense.
Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
And it's almost picked off.
Was the intended receiver on the play.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Zips it to the back. And he's level at the 30-yard line.
That makes it fourth and inches.
Meyer is the punter. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's to the 40. He's taken down at the 44.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
USC up six. Gets to about the 44-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
Fitzpatrick, the intended receiver on the play.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And they push him out right around the 48-yard line. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. He's at the 40. Gets out to around the 32. Somebody jumped early down there.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. Looks to the back and can't connect. The middle and stuffed. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. USC is up by six. He's going to go for the home run.
That makes it first and goal.
Throws this one away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 1-yard line, second down.
Defense stacked in tight here. Touchdown, Trojans.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
And he hits the PAT. A 9-play, 61-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Here's a give up the middle, tackled right away. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. There's a strike complete, and down he goes at the 35-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Makes it out to about the 49.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Gets to around the 42.
Gain of 9 on the play. That brings up second and 1.
The middle. Tackled after a decent pickup. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Passes in and it's picked off by the safety.
Now that's exactly what this defensive coordinator wanted to see. Somebody come up with a big play. Right when it looked like this team might be able to get back in the game, they come up with the big interception and maintain the momentum here in the first half.
And he's tackled around the 48-yard line.
Shelton on the tackle with the 48-yard line. First down.
And a quick throw. He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Called a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and 1.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Gain of 1 yard. That'll make it third and 1.
He's taken down at the 32.
Number 5 makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Check, check. Green 15, answer. Motion, motion, motion.
Now he's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
That brings up second and 13.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. He's got his man across the middle. Tackle at the 21.
Number 4 makes the tackle at the 21-yard line. First First down.
They come out on an empty backfield. Open receiver, no good.
Whitney was the intended receiver on the play.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Strike and he drops it. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. It's up and the field goal is good. USC is ready to kick it away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's tackled at the 21-yard line.
I think I can count on one hand the last time I saw this good a defensive performance where you had a chance for a shutout. Are you kidding me in college football today? With the spread and the running quarterbacks and all the speed and space, these guys got a chance to put up a shutout.
The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Second and 10. Ball on the 21. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Clement gets the call. They'll get him for a loss. The Trojans are going to call their second timeout. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. He's at midfield. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. USC's really putting a hurting on him right now.
Well, you wonder if it was a coach or a player who kind of lit the fire under this offense, but we've seen a completely different-looking team, and they're executing at a much higher level.
Well, the last drive was good for 3, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that.
Yeah, the defense looked a little sluggish there, and they can do better than that. Nearly
intercepted.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. And he might want it all here, and does! Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
Rodgers was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 3rd and 10.
He heaves it to the end zone. Oh, my, what a catch. Touchdown.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Throws complete and he's hit right away. So the Badgers will use their first time out of the half. It's 2nd and 5 here. Ball on the 30.
quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Number nine was the intended receiver on the play.
Two times.
That'll make it third and five.
Three down.
Hey, check right.
They keep it on the ground, and a great tackle right there. The Trojans using their third and final timeout. The defense has everybody on the line. I think they're going to come after this one. They'll bring him down at the 41. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
We've played a half of football here. USC's up by 23.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
The lead at halftime, much larger than any of us anticipated. I know I'm surprised. I can see it in your face watching the game. You're a little bit surprised. You think these coaching staffs are shocked both on both sides? One that has the lead and the other one that needs to come back?
Well, I think one side's probably going, yeah, this is just how we drew it up. But the other side's probably going, what happened? I think that it's going to be interesting in the second half because you are surprised, you are shocked, and now as a coach, you got to adjust. You got to get these guys to believe and understand that it went that way in the first half. We're not that bad. They're not that good. So let's come out in the second half and execute because our game plan will work if we continue to work. We have to have, listen, big plays have to come our way. We have to force some turnovers, but if we stay aggressive, good things can happen and we can get back in this ballgame.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Trojans continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
This defensive end just showed us why he's much more than just a pass rusher.
That makes it second and 14.
From their own 21-yard line, it's second down. And he tackles him hard at the 29. To the 40, and they make the stop at around the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10, ball on their own 44. Run left, and he's taken down in the backfield.
Loss of two on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
Throws it in a hurry. Knocked out of bounds at the 48-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Hand off, and he won't make it.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
Meyer is the punter. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold?
He's scared. Set.
And they got it. Man, it's an offensive lineman. This is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Just throws this one away. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Brought down at the 33.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
Oh, excellent punt. And he's tackled at the 34. The offense takes the field again. They were forced to punt their last time out.
Down two possessions. This offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
That makes it second and 14.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
Number three, the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 14.
Three down. Mark 55.
Nice pitch and catch for the first down. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
Most of the time, zone coverage will take away the out route. Not that time.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Pitch play to the left. He's still going. He gets hit out of bounds at the 41-yard line. Made at the 40.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 40-yard line, second down.
Ready?
And he scores! Touchdown! And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
Once he got the ball, he did all the heavy lifting to take it to the house. And they're looking to get 2 points here. And they won't get the two.
A six-play, 65-yard drive. But the failed two-point conversion keeps it a six-point score.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
And he's taken down at the 24-yard line. Wisconsin's got a little Jekyll and Hyde thing going on here on their defense.
Well, they were on their heels the entire first half. You look around now, they're flying around, making a lot of plays, and really giving themselves a chance to maybe win this game.
The defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive. He's got it out to his tight end, and he's taken down right around the 28-yard line. That reception good for around 4 yards.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Pressure coming. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Smith, the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Now it's third and six coming up. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Complete. It's the freshman. And he shoved out of bounds at the 39-yard line.
That was actually pretty good defense. But a great pass and a great catch were enough to overcome it.
The 42.
Harris was the intended receiver. That'll make it second and seven.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look. Got it and brought down immediately. Bring him down around the 48-yard line.
Number seven makes the tackle at the 48-yard line. First down.
Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here.
Three.
Caught him, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. This is the eighth play of the drive. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
That brings up third and 10.
They come out in a five-wide set. Here's a quick throw. He's taken down at the 25. And for Kessler, that last pass puts him at 300 yards for the game.
Well, this quarterback has had a solid game. He's done what's been asked of him and then some.
And even though they're comfortably in the lead, it doesn't look like they're going to stop passing the ball. And he throws it away. It's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's on the run. Slides down.
Gain of 9 on the play. That'll bring up third and inches.
Let's get off the field, D. Let's get off the field, D. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
Interception. Gain of 13 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Loss of 4 yards on the play. That brings up second and goal.
Here's play number 14 of this drive. There was some movement on the line.
Green nine.
False start. Offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a five-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
We've got second and goal. Ball on the 12-yard line.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. This is play number 15 of a very impressive drive. He's looking for six. Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. The kick is up, and the field goal is good. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
So at the end of three, USC leads it 26-6. In this very pivotal fourth quarter. And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. And they push him out around the 41-yard line. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And he's tackled right around the 48-yard line. First down. From the 48-yard line, first down. Down he goes, around the 37-yard line. First down. Going right, intercepted. He might have a chance.
Marshall makes the interception.
He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
From the 30-yard line, it's first down. They'll get him for a loss. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. Zips it to the tight end. Tackle at about the 25-yard line. Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. It has the distance. And it's off the upright, no good.
And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He makes his way to about the 45. First and 10. Ball on the 45. And they make the stop around the 34-yard line. Complete, and he stopped immediately. From the 29-yard line, it's second down. Clement on the draw. And he carries the ball for a nice game. This is the eighth play of this drive. And he's hit immediately.
Number 21 with the tackle at the 20-yard line. That makes it second.
It's second and eight. Ball on the 20-yard line. He's in trouble. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. They bring him down.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
Well, they're looking for another fourth down conversion. They've already gotten one this drive. Just under three to go in regulation. And they get the sack.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for them here.
So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. Madden takes the give. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. Positive yardage.
Call it a gain of 6 yards.
Double tight, guys. Double tight.
That'll bring up third and 2.
Three down, three down. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53.
Kill, kill, kill.
Three, 15.
Take four, take four.
takes it, and he's tackled short.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. Man, that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
It out to maybe the 29-yard line. This quarterback has certainly had better games in his college career.
Right now, the defensive pressure flat out is causing these turnovers. When you're a defensive coordinator, you want to always try to get your defense to pin their ears back and put pressure on the quarterback. When you do that, you're going to create opportunities.
He doesn't have a whole lot of time left to redeem himself. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. We have less than a minute to go. As a man, he'll lose big yards. So the Badgers taking their first time out of the half. From their own 24-yard line. Second down. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Brought down to 37-yard line. Wisconsin's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's at midfield. Tackle made around the 30-yard line.
That's a tough catch for the receiver on a ball coming in from that angle. But he did a really nice job of looking it into his hands and concentrating all the way.
Picked off, and that's going to wrap this one up. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 26-6, Trojans. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.
Got outside contained. You've got to stop them here, folks.
No, God! No, God, please, no! 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 No!
Not like this. Not like this.
And we get the big hit on Russell Wilson. What a clutch play.